Good morning, children. In last class, we are discussing about cell, the basic unit of life, part 2. In part 2, we are discussing about diversity in cells. What is meant by diversity? Different types of cells are present in our body, but not all the cells are same in shape, size, and structure. Different cells are different from one to another. So that is called diversity. That is called diversity. All the cells are surrounded by a membrane called cell membrane. Cell membrane. Inside the cell is filled with a fluid-like substance called cytoplasm. Cytoplasm. Different types of parts are present in the cell, as like we have different parts in our body. They are called cell organelles. Cell organelles. Already we know cell is called the basic unit of life. Why the cell is called the basic unit of life? Because the life of every living organism starts with a single cell. So cell is called the basic unit of life. Millions of organisms lives on the earth. But the number of cells are not same in all the organisms. The number of cells are different from one to another. Based on that, organisms are mainly categorized into two types. What are they? Unicellular organisms, multicellular organisms. What is meant by unicellular organisms? In unicellular organisms, uni means a single. Organisms with a single cell throughout the life are called unicellular organisms. What is meant by multicellular organisms? Multi means more. Organisms with two or more than two cells are called multicellular organisms. Multicellular organisms. Like that, in last class we are discussing about amoeba. Amoeba is a unicellular organism. It has no proper shape and structure. And it has a finger-like extension called pseudopodia. What is the use of pseudopodia to amoeba? It helps in locomotion. Locomotion means movement and feeding. In this class, we are discussing about different types of cells and their shapes and sizes. Okay. So, these are the different types of cells. Some of the different types of cells present in our body. If you observe all these cells, these all cells are different from one to another. This is a smooth muscle cell. This is the bone cell. The cells present in the bone. And this is the narrow cell present in our nervous system. It is a striped muscle cell. And these are the blood cells. Already you know blood cells are of different types. The main types of blood cells are red blood cells and white blood cells. Again, red blood cells are of three types. White blood cells are of mainly two types. They are granulocytes, agranulocytes. Again, granulocytes are of how many types? Three types. What are they? Basophils, neutrophils, eosinophils. Like that, agranulocytes are of two types. They are monocytes and lymphocytes. So these are some of the different types of cells present in our body. If you observe these cells, they are different in their shape, size, and structure. And different types of cells have different functions. All the cells do not have same functions. Each cell have their specific function. So let us discuss about the sizes of cells. The sizes of the cells in the living organisms are different from one to another. Some of the cells are very small in size. Some of the cells are large in size. The cells which are very small in size, we can observe them only with the help of microscope. And some of the cells are, we can see with our naked eyes. Naked eyes means we can see them directly. No need of microscope to see that cells. So let us discuss about the sizes of different cells. Sizes of different cells. Some of the cells are really smallest size. The smallest cell is zero point two microns found in bacteria. Bacteria cell. So 0.1 to 0.5 microns. Next. The size of a human and liver kidney cells are 20 to 30 microns. Okay. Size of human nerve cell nearly 90 to 100 centimeters. The size of the largest cell, egg of ostrich, is 17 centimeters into 18 centimeters. 18 centimeters. These are the sizes of different types of cells. First one, what is the smallest cell? The size of the smallest cell is 0.1 to 0.5 microns and it is a bacteria cell. It is found in bacteria. And the size of a human liver and kidney cells are 20 to 30 microns. And human nerve cells, the size of the human nerves are nearly 90 to 100 centimeters. And the largest cell, what is the largest cell? Egg of ostrich is the largest cell. We can see it without a microscope, with our naked eyes. The size of the largest cell is 17 centimeters into 18 centimeters. 18 centimeters. That is about the sizes of different types of cells. Next, the size of the cell is related to its function. Already we are discussing different cells have different functions. The size of the cell is mainly depends on its function. Okay, for example, narrow cell is taken as an example. Okay, the size of the narrow cell is nearly 90 to 100 centimeters. Either it is present in the elephant or in the human beings. Whatever it may be, the function of the narrow cell is same both in elephants and human beings. What is the function of narrow cell? Transferring messages from one place to another place. Okay, now. Okay. The size of the cell is mainly depends on its function. Actually, we thought that the organs which are present big in size have big size cell, but it is not wrong. It's not right. The size of the cell is depends on its function. And the size of the organisms, is depends on number of cells. the size of the cell is depends on its function, and the size of the organism is depends on number of cells present in them. For example, if you compared rat and elephant, generally what we thought that elephant have big size cells, that's why it is big in size. Rat has small cells, that's why it is small in size. But it's wrong. Elephant is very big in size because it has more number of cells than rat. Elephant have more number of cells, that's why it is big in size. Rat has less number of cells, that's why it is small in size. So size of the organs depends on number of cells, not on size of cells. This is very very important. Again, size of the organism depends on number of cells, not on size of cells. Okay, next, the shape. Size, structure, and function. These all are different from one cell to another cell. Okay. So today we have completed this lesson. Okay. Once we recapture what are the main points in this lesson. Okay, cell is called the basic unit of life. Why the cell is called basic unit of life? Because the life of every living organism is made up of a single cell, so it is called basic unit of life. Okay, all the living organisms are made up of with cells. In all the living organisms, you can observe two types of cells: plant cells and animal cells. Both plant cells and animal cells are different from one to another. If you compare animal cell and plant cell, both cells are surrounded by a membrane called cell membrane. If we compare both animal and plant cells, in plant cells another membrane is present over the cell membrane, that is called a cell wall. Inside the cell, the cells are filled with a fluid called cytoplasm. In cytoplasm, different types of cell organelles are present. Each one have their specific functions. First of all, who discovered the cell? Robert Hooke. Discovered the cell. When he observed a slice of cork, he observed a small empty spaces and called them as cell. Actually, cell is a which language word? Latin word. What it means? It means a little room. So this is about the diversity of cells, the shape, size, and structure of different cells, and the sizes of different cells. Okay, thank you.